All right, welcome to another one of our series of Midnight Quantum Physics Lectures with Tony. This is working out great for me, so let's just roll with it here. So last time we talked about the ideas of probability theory, and specifically probability of discrete variables and probability of continuous variables. And so what we're going to do today, and then we introduced kind of out of the blue, the Schrodinger equation with really no explanation and no rationale other than we wrote it on the board. So what we're going to do here today is we're going to kind of try to put those things together to talk about what it means to actually describe probabilities of quantum systems. And the single most important thing that we use for that is what's called this psi of x and t, which the name that we give to that is the wave function. So the first thing I want to build up here is basically I want to help us get a more intuitive idea of what this thing actually represents and how we can use that to make quantum predictions. So we'll discuss a little bit about the connections between classical probability and quantum probability based on this thing. And then we're going to proceed on to talking about how to use our knowledge of whatever this thing represents to then estimate the likelihood of, for example, finding a particle at a given position or finding a particle with a given momentum. And then once we do that, we're going to wrap the lecture up with a discussion of probability current, which essentially describes how the probability of something changes over time. But again, it's important to kind of underscore the fact that everything comes back to this wave function psi of t. And so the more that we can just have some idea of what that represents, the easier it will be for us to then build all sorts of fancy integrals and other sorts of complicated ideas based around this fundamental thing here, psi of x and t. So let's start with that.